he thought it would be a little more serious. It didn't turn into other issues were discussed, and he basically is downplaying the meeting at this point.
That would be no surprise. Are there any ties? There is some reporting that Senator Chuck Grassley has described him as having ties to Russian intelligence in the past. What is our level of reporting on that right now?
Yeah, so there are court documents that have been filed which allege that he has ties to the Russian government. Again, it all depends on who you talk to. Some folks will say, you know, he's not really that big of a player, but you know, he's a Washington guy. He does make a living lobbying, so perhaps it could be that sort of his lobbying efforts could have been mixed up into some of his other connections to the Russian government. No doubt that he has ties to the Russian government, but whether or not he's actually getting direction from the Russian government, we have not been able to confirm that.
All right. Thank you so much for this reporting. Clearly.
Hello, everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is Madden 17 on EA Sports. We've got two teams here looking to find a way to win. It's the Vikings coming in at 6-0, going up against the 49ers, who come in at 3-3. With that, let's get out to Zilker Stadium, where we're standing by all our commentators, Brandon Gotton and Charles Davis.
Larry, thank you very much. We are pleased, as always, to be bringing you coverage of the National Football League presented by EA Sports. Today, we've got a matchup here in pivotal Week 7 between the San Francisco 49ers and the Oklahoma City Bison.
I also think it's significant, and we have to bear in mind this, but I believe at this point in time, the Trump family has to deserve a protection. So
getting toward the halfway point of the NFL season, Week 7 is underway on EA Sports. This one fielded at the 5. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. They'll give it to him right up the gun. And nothing doing on his first run. Back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. Back to throw now on second and 10. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players that somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You get better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
And again, this time to the tailback. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks.
Absolutely love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed. He's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him any type of blocking. Always talk about slot receivers. They're usually known as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage.
They'll look to throw here on first down. To the sideline, and oh, a nice catch there. Made sure the feet were in bounds, and they were. Call it a gain of 3, and it'll be second down.
Let's make this one simple. What a catch, especially the finishing part of getting his feet in bounds, toe tapping, and of course, foot dragging.
What a tapestry, if you will.
Like it.
Now back to throw. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he's going to get this inside the 30. A solid gain of 15 yards in the sticks move. And they're getting him involved early.
You feel like they saw something on tape, or they just have a sense with him because he's had a good week of practice or something in that area. But they want him involved, just as you said. They want him to touch it either in the running game or the passing game, but they must like the matchups they're getting.
I think that the interesting possibility here is that given that these people are probably
This is the former Spartan from San Jose, Tyler Irvin, and taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. 12 yards there as they move the chains.
Every now and then when we see a really good run, we really tend to focus on what other people did in order for that run to happen, what the offensive line did, what the receivers did to help. Sometimes the running back's pretty good, too. And on that play, he picked up a lot of good yardage and made it happen with great effort.
A second down carry for Irvin, and he'll find his way down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. 2 yards the gain there, and now they're left with a third and about 4 for a first.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blow. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
They'll set up to throw, and it's caught. Touchdown. Their dangerous wide receiver, his fourth touchdown on the year. And this offense takes the ball down the field and scores on their opening drive. And it's good to make it 7-0. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback.
And breaking news will continue to follow at this hour, is that there are now more people involved in that June 2016 meeting at Buck County than previously.
He takes this for 3 to the 29. And a lot of the weight of this offense falls on the shoulders of the running back.
That's because the offense knows if they give him any openings, any opportunities, he can turn it into a big play at any time.
What does this mean now that this
rip continues? They'll fake the give. Now Stafford. Looking for Stills here, and it's intercepted. And now off to the races, down the right side. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. So a dangerous pass over the middle into zone coverage, and it bit him hard.
But what's really difficult when you throw it in that direction and versus that zone, that means the linebackers have gotten to their spot, gotten their heads back around, and they can see the quarterback and everything in front of them. And they took big advantage of it, went the other direction, excellent blocking, and picked up a touchdown.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. And San Francisco gets set to go here. Stafford here, coming off his pick six. He's got time in the pocket. Oh, a hit. He lost the football. Stafford puts it on the ground. And his crew will take over with a football at the 35-yard line. Out comes this offensive unit as they get set to take over here. That last drive, it's a good mix. Run, pass, run, pass. Defense on the toes.
And what really helps out in a big way is when you're doing the run-pass mix and everything's working, that means that they're guessing wrong every time on defense. They think you're going to pass when you run and vice versa. I would continue that, and when they finally draw a bead on him, maybe you mix it up a little bit with play action and throw the ball.
And will they maintain that balance? Time to find out. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's 2nd and 9.
A 1 yard gain can look like a disaster, but it all depends on how the game is going. Is it a series of 1 yard gains running the ball? If that's the case, you might have to start thinking about throwing it a little bit more. But if it's just the occasional 1 yard run, hey, congratulations to the defense. They won that one. Come back and get them the next time.
It's an 8-yard pickup, and that'll bring up a 3rd and 1.
And this one will have a huge red flag if they thought, oh gosh, we got to cover this up.
So just 1 yard to go here on 3rd down.
they would have said, let's come out.
They come out with one back and three tight ends. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he is going to lose yardage here. Losing 4 yards that time. And now it's fourth down.
And partner, in a lot of short yardage situations, you'll see the linebackers step up into the gaps, what we call mugging the line of scrimmage, to make sure they take away all spaces, all creases. That one worked really well for them.
Now only needed a yard, instead went backwards. So the drive stalls out, but they are able to put 3 points on the board.
Yeah, just a yard or two shorter than an extra point. So no problems converting there.
And now the 49er offense ready to go and getting back out onto the field. And the turnover last time, that's sort of been symptomatic of their struggles here in this one.
Big word. I like it, though, because you're exactly right.
That, don't you?
All game long, they've struggled moving the ball, turning it over on the last possession. Is that word again symptomatic?
Yeah.
I like that.
Your analysis. And the pressure gets to him and brings him down. Stafford is sacked. Leonard Williams in there to get him. Sack number 14 for him on the year. To throw on second down to Stafford. Finding time. He's going to, and got his man complete. Pass the 20. Touchdown, 49ers. Dez Bryant, 84 yards. And the 49ers are able to strike quickly for 6. Good pass, clean catch, and a house call there on the fly route.
And not that much room to operate. So that tells you about his acceleration. We always talk about being able to go from 0 to 60 real fast. Took him less time than that to get to top speed and complete that play.
And following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. This one fielded at the 5. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. Now this offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. And they split the uprights last time for 3. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking, because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Run what you do best. Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead the big way. The best way to do it? Touchdowns.
They'll give it to him right up the gut. And they'll bring him down after just a short pickup. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
I do know from experience that if you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback, because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt. I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right, whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs, in this case, the feet, doing a little toe tap to stay in bounds and complete the catch.
And a great job by our crew on the camera shot. Love when you see the grass or on the field turf, those rubber pellets flying up. Great catch. Nothing doing on that one. It'll be 4th down.
And every snap, the defense is trying to establish who they are. But on 3rd and short, that's really when you put it out there and tell people who you are. And that's exactly what they did. For the offense, they look at their offensive line and say, guys, where are you? We need you on those plays.
Brennan Gordon, Charles Davis back with you as it's OKC football here to begin quarter number 2. And they're on the move here. They've got it 1st and 10. They come out here in the eye. They go play action here on 1st down. He's going to let it go deep for the end zone. And they went big on 1st down.
There is no evidence that there were any bow
drills, right, trying to get their feet down inbounds. But a lot of the times what we don't talk about is when they're up in the air and they catch the ball, you ever notice how they're reaching back with their feet, not just straight down, but back, because they're trying to create enough distance to make sure their feet are in bounds. They weren't able to get it done on that one, though.
He'll try again with the arm here on 2nd down. This is caught at the end. And he will take this one in for a touchdown. Their big tight end. His 3rd touchdown now on the year. And his guys are going to add on to their lead. the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This will be taken very short. And they're going to have really good starting field position here as that's taken up close to the 40. And San Francisco gets set to go here. Last time they were out, they scored. Still trailing here, though, so some work to do.
But it's okay in terms of mindset. Because they scored the last time, they're not quite as worried about being down on the scoreboard because now their confidence is a little bit higher. They feel like they've got something going, and they feel like they can attack again and put more points on the board.
Are you scoreboard watching if you're the offense, or are you just focused on this drive?
We wouldn't be telling the truth if we said that they didn't scoreboard watch. Everyone does it to some extent. But you've got to set it aside right now and just focus on this series. That'll take care of the scoreboard if they punch it into the end zone.
They send Stills in motion. On first down, Stafford here. And he hits his target. It's Kenny Stills. 12 yards that time for number 12 as they move the chains. And a nice little pass and catch there on the corner route.
Set up very well by the receiver with a head and shoulder fake inside before he comes back downhill to his quarterback.
And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. On first down at Stafford. He's got time. His throw caught right around the 6. And across the chalk into the end zone. It's a 49er touchdown. Their big tight end. His 4th touchdown on the year. And the 49ers get a score closer. Following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Now this offense ready to head back out there. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went. No adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away. We talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and is accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
The defense won that play so fast that I think if the running back even had time to notice if anyone was there, it was just a blink of an eye, and there was a loss on the play.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Now a handoff here to his running back, and he's going to get this one down to the 45. 5 yards on the carry there, and it leaves him with 3rd and about 6 yards to go.
On a 2nd and long, it's really nice to see an offense that has enough confidence to run the football in that situation. I think that goes back to their practice and game planning. They've seen things that they've seen on tape and in previous games that led them to believe that even in a long-distance situation, they can still run the football and gain enough yardage to put themselves in a good spot on 3rd down.
2 minutes gone by, 2nd quarter. And they're going to go soft on the corners. They come out here in the eye. They'll look to throw now on 1st down. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. Give him a couple on the catch. It's 2nd and 8.
I know the halftime's approaching, but I don't think he's going to want to take a break. That's his 5th catch.
Yeah, they've really been targeting the tight end. Eight yards to go here on 2nd down. They'll drop the throw. The ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
It's always tough trying to keep your guy upright when he's trying to throw the football. When you're dealing with those big, bad guys on the defensive front, it's even tougher. And this time, those guys on the opposite side won the battle, getting to the quarterback and knocking him into an incompletion.
On 3rd down, Irvin. And not much of a hole there as he gets it down to about the 24-yard line. It'll be a gain of 4, but it won't be enough. It leaves him with a 4th down now. comes a field goal team now for the second time here today. He connected on his first, this from 41. And his kick is good. And that will stretch the lead up to 13. So it goes down as an 8-play drive, and they cap it with the field goal.
Yeah, they were able to pick up a few first downs along the way, but it couldn't keep the momentum going all the way into the end zone.
It's a very short kick taken by an up man. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. Out on the field now, here come the 49ers. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
And it takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that. Now a play fake here on first down. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs. Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. Now a first down throw. Stafford is going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete. Nothing on that one. It'll be second down.
When a linebacker is able to sit at the second level and see things develop in front of him, as soon as he got a hint that the quarterback was checking it down, he just made a beeline directly for the receiver and ended up making the play.
Now a play faking at Stafford. On the left side, this is Stills. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. So 2 minutes to go in a wild first half. We'll come back here right after this.
There is a cloud over the White House.
So here we go, first and 10 now. They go play action here on first down, surveying the field. He's going to fire one deep, middle of the field, and it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
It looked like they had something there, but I think that he was thinking about running with the football before he actually hauled it in, and that led to a big drop.
Second and 10, Stafford again. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. A good job defensively to hold that to 4 yards, and now it's third down. And at his size, he's a smaller back. You can get him the football. He can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime.
They're going to have to pull out of the arena. They're going to have to stop moving the fence in Georgia. And for anyone to expect us to understand and trust them and give them back locations in which they were spying on us is simply absolutely ludicrous and against the best interest of the United States.
And they'll need to get to the 35 if they want to keep this drive going on third down. Off of play action. Here's Stafford. And he'll be hit as he releases it. And that'll fall incomplete.
One of the great coaches said football is really a simple game. Rush theirs, protect yours. And he's talking about those guys throwing the football. In this situation, the rush won, hitting the quarterback and forcing him into an incompletion.
And I tell you what, he got it from 58. That had lots of leg behind it. So it's a 7-play drive, but it stalls out in the end.
Let's credit the defensive front seven. They were a little leaky at the start of the drive, but they stiffened toward the end.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. And now back out comes the offense. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had a field goal last time, and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just settle for 3, except in certain situations, trying to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time, it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as they begin this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes out there saying, hey, let's get three, right?
Not one that I've ever met.
There he goes, right side, and all the way in for the touchdown. A great play there with touchdown number 7 on the year. And his guys find a way to stretch that lead. And he's able to put it through. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This will be taken short. And San Francisco gets set to go here. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put 6 on the board here. We'll see. They'll fake it. Now Stafford. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down. Creeping up on a minute to play in this first half. On second down, here's Stafford. Out to the flat, that's complete to his running back. They'll get nothing out of that one, and it's going to lead to a third down.
Brandon, just mark that under the category of just not successful. Trying to throw the ball, just didn't work on that one.
Completed it. No yardage. And they're going to speed things up here. From the gun on third down, Stafford. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Aaron Lynch. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. Now this offense ready to take over again. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
But that's the type of pass play that you need to wait for routes to develop. You need a little time in the pocket. But that's hard to do when you got people in your face.
They come out here in the eye. They'll throw now on the final play. They'll roll him out right. Now on the run, he'll throw. That's caught inside the 20. Hey, Charles, do you need water? Jeez, Chuck, they cut off the halftime show again. Quicker than anticipated, ready for the start of the second half. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Here comes the 49ers offensive unit. It's they'll have it first to begin this third quarter. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this is a real,
I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down.
And that's a good sign right there as we start the third quarter. Because in the first half, not much space to run the football. And as we go into the half, we often think to ourselves, all right, what's the adjustment? What do they have to do? You know what a lot of the adjustments are? No adjustments. You know the game plan, been working on it all week. Maybe a little tweak here or there, a little bit better blocking. And now you're establishing the running game.
On first down, Stafford here. That one complete to Anderson. 11 yards on the pickup, and it'll be first down, 49ers.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
And now here's a carry heading left. And the lane closes up quickly as he'll get about three down to the 38.
Partner, we know today's NFL really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
Here's Stafford now at second down. He's got his man on the crossing route. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks. And there they went crossing route against the zone defense. What do you think of that?
It takes real coordination between the passer and the receiver because you've got to read those zones and where the open spots are and be on the same page with the guy throwing the football. Because sometimes you're throwing it in front of the zone, sometimes you're throwing it between the zones, sometimes the receiver's going to just kind of find a spot and what we call sit down and present himself to the quarterback and throw it there. It's a tough read, but when they're in sync, it's really effective.
Time running out here on the play clock. Play clock down to two, and we get a signal and a timeout. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter.
If there was some egregious evidence that came out about
for the offense lining up first and 10.
It's on the table. I don't see this happening. This is, again, this idea that he's going to lose his third place. It's one of those things that's going to form this.
Now a play fake here on first down. On the move to his left. And this is incomplete. Dez Bryant, the intended receiver. That'll bring up second down. Shift together here from the D-line. On second and 10, Stafford. It's caught, Stills, right side. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. They give him 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs.
In recent years, the slot receivers really gained stature in the NFL because they could do so many things. Yes, they can line up wide like your normal wide receiver, but they have that kind of courage and toughness to run routes in the middle of the field and become dependable targets for their quarterbacks and move the sticks. Those guys are worth their weight in gold.
No gain on the play there. It'll be second down.
And as we've seen throughout this season, it's no picnic trying to score touchdowns against this unit. They're ranked number one against the run. But it's also difficult because it's not easy to throw the ball against them either.
To throw on second down is Stafford. Throwing for his running back and he's got him complete. It's a gain of 5 on the play. And just like that, it's third down. Looked like a pretty good, safe play right there. No, he's had trouble with the interceptions in this game there. Hits his guy on the flat.
Hey, so many times we hear quarterbacks and offensive coordinators talk about, in your progressions, you're either throwing the touchdown or you're throwing the check down. But earlier in the game, it was touchdown or interception.
Now a battle for the football. It's caught. It's a touchdown. Steven Anderson, his first touchdown on the year. And the 49ers make some inroads here on the deficit. And he's got it up and through. And following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. This one fielded at the 5. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They go play action here on first down. Under a heavy rush and down he goes. It'll be a loss of 10. And it'll bring up second. And now they're in the hurry up. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And the window closes quickly. He'll only get up to the 22-yard line. And they only get a yard back there. They'll be left with a third down and long.
Well, praise has to go to the guys on the offensive line because they've had a very nice, productive day running the football. How about that poor defensive line? They've been knocked around the entire game. And while they slowed him down on that run, can they continue to do so? Because they haven't had much success throughout this ball game.
Hit as he throws there, incomplete. Well, the numbers have been good in the passing game, and certainly a big reason why they have the lead. But now here, third quarter, maybe go to the run game a little more?
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, after that incompletion, a little credit to the defense for shutting them down on that play. Maybe you try and run the football a little bit more in this spot. But they have to feel good about how they've been throwing it overall.
And he'll go ahead and field this at the five. Shrugs the tackle.
Nice.
Nice job on the return there, 16 yards. And the offense will come back onto the field for the first and 10. The San Francisco offense getting their last-minute instructions before they take over here. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. So they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch-counter-punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got to a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you think to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
If you love pressure, we'll see if they dial it up this drive.
Today's NFL, these big guys are featured receivers. They move all over the place to try and find good matchups. And they had one. They were just unable to complete the pass.
Unable to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's second. Second down. Second and 10, Stafford again. Flushed out right. Now he's going to throw it back deep over the middle. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
Help me out, partner. Was that incomplete?
That was on a deep ball to Dez.
And that's a surprise. The way he attacks the football in the air, it's always surprising to me when he doesn't complete a pass like that.
Stafford. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. It'll be a gain of 8, but it also lead to a fourth down.
So much about offense is what you call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job of limiting that and keeping them from a first down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks. And he finds Stills, complete. It'll be a gain of 8 yards. And on fourth down, they're able to convert and move the sticks. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10.
We always hear about guys wanting to make plays that quiet a crowd. After that one.
Here in the third quarter, they were hoping to get the stop, get the football back. Not the case.
What a completion on a fourth down play.
Really nice little connection there. They go with the corner route, and it works out well.
And the best way to set up the corner route is to throw slants throughout the ball game so that when you're able to get back outside, the defender has to respect the inside game.
7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive.
Now that's staying ahead of the chains. Really good pickup on first down, hitting the tight end there. Now brings up a second and manageable.
Just found a hole in that zone. Welcome back, everybody, to Oklahoma City. Second down.
Well, it's been the air game that's taken them down on this drive before they finally turned around and handed it off on the last play.
And now they're looking for the big boys to get them in the end zone. Couldn't do it there.
It'd be interesting to see. Offensive lines had to pass block a lot on this drive. Will they be able to revert and fire out and create some space in the run game?
And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, San Francisco. Their big body receiver, his second touchdown on the season. And the 49ers are back within a score. And following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. And here now the offense heading back out there. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short. Well, they'll take that every time with a lead, first down, fourth quarter, getting 8 yards. You love that.
They will take it, and you have to ask the defensive guys, why did you give it? I mean, you know the situation. You're down, have to stop them, have to get the football back. But 8 yards on first down puts them back on their heels.
It'll go as a gain of six that time, and it moves the chains as well. And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. They come out here in the eye. And on the ground they go with a running back. And not much room to operate as they'll get this up only to about the 41. The fourth quarter here, they got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up in the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
Give them three on the run there. Now they're looking at a third and about five.
I think we know by now that every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone. But these short ones still have their value. You can still set up the play action and throw the football. You control the clock because you have the ball and they don't. And often the physicality sets the tempo for the game.
And 12 yards in time and picking up the first.
When a coaching staff sees their team run the ball this successfully in the fourth quarter, they're really excited because you can plan for a running game all you want and want to press that advantage when you get it. But for the most part, it's a little bit of a surprise. And right now, they're going to keep that going, want to continue to grind out the clock because it's definitely in their favor at this stage of the game. Can they close the game out and continue to do exactly what we just saw there? And that's run the football.
He'll drop to throw to the sideline, and oh, that's well done. Able to drag the feet, he's going to have the first down. He's been a busy man here in this one, and they're showing off some nice footwork to stay in bounds.
And with those types of catches and the volume that we've seen in this game, wouldn't you keep him busy as well?
I would.
Of course, you got to keep throwing it to him. He keeps making plays.
On first down, Irvin. And he's going to take this one down to the 25. A solid run on first down. Gain of seven. Leaves him with a second and three. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. Back to throw here. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. A great read and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And San Francisco gets set to go here. And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. After the interception, here's Stafford. He's got time in the pocket. He's gonna. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. Touchdown, 49ers. Kenny Stills, 81 yards. And the 49ers have moved out in front here in the fourth quarter.
Did you see them hold up four fingers to the start of the fourth quarter?
They were ready.
They were definitely ready. They may or may not have done that, but they certainly have played that way. The fourth quarter has belonged to them, and now the lead belongs to them as well.
And following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. So out now comes the offense back onto the field. Looked like they had something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory they need to keep with them is that they did have something going. They were moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence going. Don't worry about the other part. You can't get that back. Let's go back to what you were doing well before.
So you were going to say they need to have no memory, but remember the good part, forget the bad.
I like that even better.
And a nice carry there of 15 yards.
And he continues to pile up the yardage. That puts him over a buck 50 now. And this defense has really had its problems trying to keep him contained.
3:39! And they'll run it here. And he'll push this forward only to about the 42-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
The entire team, 24 times, is square
So this offense really needs to make something happen here late in the fourth with the football.
Here goes the three, 39.
Looking to throw. He'll find his big tight end over the middle. A very solid gain of 27. Well, we haven't been shortchanged on offense. Another fun play to watch there on the deep pass.
This game has the feel of, what, a turkey bowl, a Thanksgiving Day. You know, when we get together this year, when the Davises and the Gaudens get together, that's what our playbook's going to look like they're drawing them up in the dirt. And so far, it's working for both of them.
Do you think they did?
Time right, time right.
I think that there was coordination.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 13 yards there on the pickup. And it's good enough for a first down.
I know anytime you watch a team run the ball really well, there's some pinball effect, people bouncing off of each other. There's also some things of beauty in there. We see these nice, explosive, strong runs. And this guy, he knows how to carry the football really well and continually wants the football. Why? He knows the offensive line's going to give him great effort, and he gives great effort himself to finish off runs.
Back to throw. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. Now we've got whistles and a timeout here. Yeah, it looks like we've got a 49er that's down on the field. We'll check on his status when we get back. And here comes play number 6 on this drive. They come out here in the eye. Back to throw. And it's caught. Touchdown. Their dangerous wide receiver with his second touchdown of the game and fifth on the year. And his guys have taken the lead here in the fourth.
And touchdown and congratulations and zero relaxation ahead of them, right? Way too much time on the clock for them to start celebrating.
Part one is done, but now on the sideline, you can already see them scrambling down there. They're getting those defensive guys ready.
Yes, you have to get those guys ready, and you also have to talk to your special teams guys. Make sure the kickoff is exactly what you want and cover it well.
So a very short kick here. This will be taken by one of the up men. And they're going to wind up with pretty good starting field position as they get it up past the 35. The 49ers offense now, they work their way back onto the field. They're only in need of a field goal, a decent amount of time on the clock. So tell me if I'm wrong. You don't have to be too panicked here.
No, not at all. I agree with you. And this is where your preparation and your confidence comes into play. They've worked on these situations.
They practice this all the time.
They know what they want to get done. And in a lot of cases, the great competitors, they love this situation. They think they can go ahead and get it done.
They practiced it. We'll see if practice makes perfect. Second down now after the incompletion. Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. He's back to throw. Wide open receiver complete. It's a pickup of 15 and a fresh set of downs. And on that last play there, he's over 400 yards passing now.
You know what that generally means?
Success.
That, and it means you really didn't miss opportunities. Usually very accurate. The ball's getting to the right place. Guys are making yardage after the catch to help you out that way. I mean, the whole team has picked it up. And don't forget, that means the offensive line has had to pass protect pretty well, too.
Everyone dialed in. They'll look to throw. Oh, he dropped it. They were looking for him in the middle third. He couldn't catch it. Now third down. And he's certainly not a guy that drops that football very often.
Indeed, because that's a bit of a surprise. I know he's in the middle of some traffic and people and bodies all around him, but he usually has the focus to haul that one in.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. Officially a gain of just a yard there, but they do convert on third and inches. And he clocks it with just 10 seconds left.
Thank you so much, Ben. Hello, Brian K. Baldwin. Welcome to After Hour. As we move to control, we'll look for a position and when a
timeout coming on the defensive side of the ball. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. Second down and 10. Defense really showing respect to the deep ball here, playing off the receivers. He'll look to throw. Finding time. They find some open field here. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It'll be their third and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside. And this one is right through. And in the fourth quarter, this game is tied. It's a little teaching moment here. Overtime rules. Remind us how this goes, partner.
Okay, so in the past, we had sudden death. First team to score wins, but no longer. Now, if the team receives the ball, scores a touchdown, they win the game. If they kick a field goal, though, or don't score, the other team gets a possession. And after both teams get a possession, then we're into sudden death. First team to score wins the game.
This will be taken very short. And they're going to have really good starting field position here as that's taken up close to the 40. The 49ers offense now, they get set to head back on the field. They're set for their first drive here in overtime. And this is where the crowd can really become a factor.
They've had to battle it all day, but I know what you're saying. In overtime, that gets doubled, doesn't it? At least, because now the crowd really wants to be involved and help their team. And that first drive can dictate the whole thing because they know if this team takes it downfield and scores a touchdown, it's game over.
It's been loud in here so far. On first down, Stafford here. That one complete to Anderson. A gain of 6 there on first.
Partners, a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about 3 different routes and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the ball as we just saw there.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And no room to maneuver there. Give him a yard up to the 47. Credit the tackle there to Aaron Lynch.
Tough day, tough sledding right there. And it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. In motion comes the tight end left. Stafford on third down. And he's got it. Got his man on the end route. Complete. Give him 6 yards, and they do convert on third.
He went full scale, loose, flexible, finding a way to catch the ball in some traffic for a key first down.
Yeah, really a nice job of adjusting to the ball in the air. Not the most accurate of throws, but able to adjust and make the grab. Stafford on first down. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. It's a gain of 6 on the play, and that'll make this a second down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
4 yards remaining now on second down. Play action, Stafford. He's got time. He's going to loft it deep right sideline. And he can't hang on. That's definitely going to be one he wishes he had back. Incomplete in the end zone.
Well, partner, I think the defensive fellas got the memo, and they decided to cover him on that play.
Yeah, he's already up over 100 yards in this game. They tried a deep shot, couldn't get it.
Yeah, when you've had that much success, finally, someone said, let's try and put a stop to it and put people on him.
And they get 10 yards there and convert on third.
Would it be safe to say that as precise as routes are supposed to be run in the NFL, maybe they're not quite as precise in college ball?
That's accurate, yeah.
And I think we saw a college route in the NFL there. Just find the soft spot, find the dead zone, and find the first down. And that's what he just did.
Shipped together here from the D-line. Play clock winding down. Stafford now to throw. And he just gets rid of it. Throws it away. The wide move there. Looked like nobody open. Now second down. On second and 10, Stafford. And he comes back with one complete. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. Well, he flew past 200, 300, 400 yards. Now he's over 450 yards passing on the day.
So what you're saying is oxygen for everyone catching the ball and trying to defend?
Yeah, especially those guys trying to defend right now.
No doubt. They've got to be a confused group because they haven't been able to defend
it. Oh, a hit. He lost the football. Stafford puts it on the ground. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And his guys are going to take over at the 21-yard line. Comes this offensive unit as they get set to take over here. Their defense did its job, got the stop. All they need is three, and this is over.
Couldn't have done much else other than score themselves and end it, but they turned it back over to them, and now all they need is a field goal to win the game. Excellent job by the defense. How can the offense finish things off?
Part one is done, now part two. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
Yeah, that wasn't a big run, just a short one there. But guess what? Sometimes you treat it like boxing. You throw that jab out there, and you throw it again, you throw it again, then you come with a big punch later. Maybe they're just trying to set them up.
They come out here in the eye. They'll set up a throw. He'll buy some time right. And he's just going to throw this one out of bounds here. Nowhere to go with it. Incomplete.
Let's face it, perfection is something we all chase, whether it's playing this game or whatever we do. Hard to attain, but that's what they were searching for as that pass goes incomplete.
And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. And a short gain there as he'll get it up only to about the 24. Okay, so interesting here. A field goal would win this thing. But the kicking team on the sideline, and they're going for it on fourth down. And it is incomplete. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And the Niners take over in terrific field position. And San Francisco gets set to go here. Neither team scored yet. Now we go to sudden death. Next points win this game.
How about the tension right now? It is ratcheted up, isn't it? I mean, now whatever happens, points are scored. That's your ball game. Can't wait to see the defense now. Do they get a little more aggressive in order to not let the team just drive the ball easily down the field?
Got to be careful, though, right?
Yeah, if you're too aggressive, you just give up something easy and cheap. But some defensive coordinators, they'd rather take a stand that way as opposed to being nickel and dime down the field.
And to give this time to the tailback. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. No gain, and it's second down. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. Back to throw now on second and 10. To the sideline, and oh, a nice catch there. Made sure the feet were inbounds, and they were.
There's a completion to the tight end, and I think they were looking at something out of central casting, frankly.
Absolutely.
I mean,
size, the hands.
Speed. I mean, can flat out run. You put that whole package together, you light up the eyes of an offensive coordinator, don't you?
They come out here in the eye. And they'll go ground game here with a tailback. Just a yard on the run there, and that's going to bring us to a fourth down. A big call here in overtime. They're going for it on fourth down. 2 minutes to go here in overtime. We'll be back after this. NFL teams last year, a little under 50% on fourth down conversions. This is a bit tougher. Fourth and 4. Down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. And the 49ers going to take another timeout.
And the fact that it was off the record, then it went on the record, it just makes it all.
They'll be left with just one remaining here at OT.
And let's not also forget the
the ground. And he'll be tackled right on the midfield logo. Given 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
And they'll go with a ground attack here. And he's brought down. A nice carry there of 15 yards.
Good, skillful, tough running throughout this contest. Picked up first down after first down. He's got to have a nickname, doesn't he? How about the human first down machine? I think that fits.
And on the ground they go with a running back. And a short gain down to about the 33. Give him a couple on the carry there. 2nd and 8. Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. They'll be down to just 1 remaining as we step aside here in overtime. They come out here in the eye. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he gets stopped up at the 31 after a gain of maybe a yard. So it's 3rd and 6, and this will be the 8th play of the drive. And they'll run it here. Call it no gain there, and it leads to a 4th down. Now hang on here. Timeout called. Timeout called by the defense. So that will be their 3rd and final in this overtime session. And as they talk it over, we take a break. We'll be right back. And he got it.
White House and Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell is that while there are some significant changes in this bill, it's not the dramatic overhaul that some of these senators, especially the ones that are holding out, were hoping for. It's a 172-page bill. We can't get through the whole thing, but let me give you some of the top lines. But one of the big things happening here is that there's a...
Tomorrow. Saturday? Mm-hmm. You said she's going over there Saturday, no? What's your plans after? You mean? What are you talking about? You didn't ask her yet?
I didn't